A very good afternoon to all of you. My name is Ashwini Kumar Kota, and on behalf of my company Excel Pro, I welcome you all today to this micro webinar on social learning in the time of social distancing. It's a very unique time we are in right now, where things have changed across the globe and all of us are confined to our homes and we have not been able to work from our offices for quite some time. In this time of social distancing, where you can't be close to your people or to your office, how do you go about learning? Trainings have been cancelled, workshops are cancelled, e-learning is happening, but when you shift completely onto online learning, can you engage your learners socially to make it more impactful and powerful? That's the agenda of this webinar today. When you're confined in the box, think out of the box. That's the kind of mindset I would like you to have when we run through this webinar today. Primarily, when I mean a box, metaphorically, I mean being confined in a home or an apartment or a room. You need to think outside the box, which would mean take your thoughts out to your audience and how well can we connect. So at the same time, how creative can you be in your communication? Can we do things we've not done earlier? Can we look at a different dimension of learning altogether? That's the opportunity which has come in front of us, and we are going to see how well we can utilize this opportunity today. I would like to share something interesting with you. Constraints can lead to creativity. Normally, we feel constraints are always bonding, blocking, creating problems for us. Oh my God, how do I work now? My computer is in the office, my teams are somewhere else, my workshops are canceled. But constraints have got a very different and very strange way of bringing out creativity. For example, the world famous merengue dance. This particular dance form was born from chained slaves as they cut sugarcane to beat of drums. So when I say the famous merengue dance, a very unique dance form, which is world famous, was born when they were slaves, human beings were slaves chained together, cutting sugarcane to the beat of drums. Now, what could be worse than this? When you're chained, don't have any human rights, and you're supposed to be cutting at the beat of a drum. But that's when the entire merengue form came in. So can we use the situation which we're in, the lockdowns which we're in, to create something like a merengue for ourselves in the learning space? That's an opportunity we'd like to explore. So these are not normal circumstances. And because these are not normal circumstances, they call for extraordinary approaches to making things happen. And that's why I took a few minutes in the beginning of this webinar to get your perspective that we are not talking of some just tools like some techniques here. We are talking about a mindset. Can I be more creative? Can I look at the opportunity in this adversity to transform the way I run my workshops and training programs? How do you go about it? First and foremost, it's time to put your creative thinking hat on. So now onwards, you have to think creatively. You know your content, you know your audience. Can you think creatively in terms of what else can I do? What more can I do? Put a learning strategy in place that was unimaginable till a few days ago. Maybe the game changer now. There were some constraints earlier too, different kinds of constraints. But the kind of learning strategy you talk about right now is going to use the opportunity you have right now, your time, your technology, is not going to leverage upon the physical constraints we had earlier to bring people together to a room, etc. The times have changed. The lockdown will not last forever, but your social learning story can. If you transform the way you learn or take your learning element to the next level, for all you know, this might be a game changer story in your career and something you might be very proud of as time passes by. So, how do you build a social learning approach? I've got some thoughts I'll share with you, something which I feel is really doable and you can do it, but it requires a lot of drive, motivation, creativity, enthusiasm. The spirit in you has to be strong and it will work out. First and foremost, initiate with a build-up of the context. So when we talk of learning interventions, most of us are unfortunately hardwired into training programs. No. Remove the layer of training programs, you'll find that there is a topic, there's a content, there's a learner, and deep inside there's a seed, which is the learning context. What is the context of learning? If you look at the context, you'll say, okay, this was the learning element. Then look at the presentations and content in front of you. Segregate them to smaller elements, bite-sized elements, which you know I cannot break it even further. When you have those points coming in, one training program might probably split into 20 or 25 small bite-sized interventions. Now, don't jump onto the bandwagon and say, okay, I got technology, I got social media, I'll do social learning. Don't do that. Now that you've got the bite-sized learning interventions, keep those in front of you. Take the first bite-sized intervention, the first element, the first small sub topic you've got. Keep it in front of you. And use scenario-based competitions to build interest. Now, I'm presuming that we are engaging on a particular platform. The platform could be your LMS, where there's a learning management system on which you got a forum, a chat forum, communication forum. You might be working on a WhatsApp group. You might be working on Facebook groups, on LinkedIn groups, or any other group. The whole idea is that your learners and you have to come together. It could even be a Skype or even Google Hangouts. For us right now, technology is not a disabler. It's an enabler. So any element of technology which is helping you to communicate with your learners together in a group, that's perfectly fine. Choose whatever is appropriate for you, whatever you're comfortable, and get on with it. How do you get on? Use scenario-based competitions to build interest. Create a small scenario, write a small scenario. Take an image, put a text, and have a curiosity angle and shoot off the image with a voice tag of yours. It might work wonders. The idea is you're not launching a program. You're inducing curiosity on a topic where a person says, okay, what is this? At a time when you're confined at home and trying to figure out how to work from home, even if you figured out trying to make things work, situations are not as great as they're supposed to be. In this, when a curiosity is kindled, some creative angle comes in, people do see it like a breath of fresh air and they will latch onto it. Will all of them latch onto it? Not necessarily. So you'll gauge the learner's interaction doubling time. Now, doubling time is something which all of us are familiar right now, because when you look at a virus and its spread, it's always gauged in terms of doubling time. How many days is it taking to double? And people keep a watch on that to see what is the extent of damage you're looking at. But in our world, doubling time is not like that. In our world, doubling rate is something beautiful, which means today, if two people responded to your scenario, tomorrow, can I get four or six people to respond to the second stimulus, the third stimulus? So keep on giving stimulus to bring people onto that group or platform to engage with you softly and nicely. And when they're doing that, automatically you see that you've got the pioneers, the followers, the laggards, and the naysayers. Pioneers are people who are always hyperactive or superactive. When you send a stimulus, they respond immediately. Followers are like, they say two, three stimulus, then they say, okay, fine, I'll come, I'll connect back with you. The laggards are the probably bottom 20%. You keep on sending stimulus, others are responding, they see a lot of action happening. Finally, they say, okay, fine, let me jump onto the bandwagon. The naysayers are the ones who don't believe in anything, it will not work kind of a mindset people. Can you convert them into a new case? If you got five naysayers and one of them actually says something in the middle of the conversation, you have a conversion there, a new case. So of the pioneers in a group, can you increase the numbers, followers numbers, laggards numbers, naysayers numbers? How long does it take? Probably 3 days. In this 3 days or 2 days, what are you doing? You're giving a stimulus. You're giving a stimulus of one, two, three super engaging interventions. Only thing is there's always an image, there's always a text and a bit of an audio of yours. But the point what you're making is what is inducing the person to think and respond to the stimulus. All the while, you're not talking about any training here. You're only building stimulus to the first micro topic of yours. When you do that, you are actually prepping up. Now, before every run, there has to be a warm up. And before every leap, there has to be a run up. So whether you call it a warm up or a run up, when you have to embark on this journey, people have to come prepared. And this is how you're prepping them. Suddenly launching of something in the form of social engaging workshops, etc., is not the ideal approach. Warming up, prepping up for at least 2-3 days is very important to get people oriented. You don't have to tell them something. They'll feel it. They'll get latched on. Social is all about getting together and feeling together. It's not about telling somebody to do something. Next. Once you're done with these things, you're comfortable that of the, say, 20 people, 3-4 have responded. Of the 100 people, 20 responded. You have the buzz running. Don't wait for more than 20% people to keep responding. There's time for that. Right now, if 20% have responded, you can get on to the next activity. That is, launch a live interactive online session. People should know you and your style of engaging, and they should be able to hear you, listen to you, and connect with you. So what I normally recommend is, after you're done with the initial part, go ahead and launch a live interactive online session using any platform of your choice. Now, the trick here is that the audience can be a public audience, the audience can be your organization's audience, the audience could be your departmental audience. Earlier, you might be doing 20 workshops across 20 locations, but now all the audience of 20 workshops can be brought together to this one single intervention, and collectively they might make up a larger pool, and they might have a larger social influence on each other to jump onto the bandwagon. Next, once you engage them with a live interactive online intervention, immediately record and put the video up. You might be doing it on Hangout, on Skype, or any of this medium. GoToWebinar, I'm using such a tool. You can use any of these tools, it's your choice. But once you do that, record and put it up. For a simple reason, while you're doing live, people are listening to you. Sometimes they might want to replay again, think it, make notes, come back. Or some of them might have just missed out and they might want to join in later on. So you have to help them do it when they want to do it by giving them a video. After you give them a video, don't rest easy. Your work has just begun. When you launch off a live online program, you're just doing a synchronous live session. The social angle has not kicked in yet. It only was used for warming up the audience. After the module has been delivered, that is when you keep it live beyond the module. So you'll follow it up with a focused discussion in a dedicated forum. Now, this is where the heart of the matter lies. The story continues beyond the launch. So after you complete the live intervention, you would have said something in the intervention, spoken something, discussed something, but I'm sure it was fantastic and passionate. After that, you have to follow it up with a focused discussion in a dedicated forum, not like a public chat room. Create a conversation forum either on the LMS you have got or a WhatsApp group or Skype group or any group, anything which suits you. When you look at any technology where all of you are comfortable, what happens over there in that collective group of learners and you, you start putting in focused discussion topics where you engage trigger topics. Trigger for what? Trigger not for action. Trigger to induce competitive engagement. So a person might want to respond to what you're saying or share his thoughts or opinions. Now, when a person shares his thoughts or opinions, automatically others jump in and they've got some opinions too. Opinions are highly viral. They tend to have an impact on others. I have an opinion. Suddenly somebody else also shares his opinion. And then three more people share their opinion. Opinion sharing is very easy once it is started. Let them share it. But more importantly, moderate it. Never have an unmoderated session because it can go haywire and the topic might lose its effect. It might turn into some different kind of session altogether. Moderating is a responsibility to ensure that the entire discussion is channelized in the direction of learning what you are looking at and induce lots of discussion. So moderate, induce. So automatically the energy gets channelized and people focus. So initially it will take a lot of effort for you to kindle the fire, but once it takes on, you're only moderating and managing it. And then the collectively people start sharing their views, thoughts, opinions, and a good discussion never dies easily. Learning happens automatically. Now, how long is too long for this? You cannot keep it too short. You cannot keep it too long. So when the discussion reaches the peak, when everybody is solidly engaged and conversations are tempoing, but you know the point you wanted to make has been made. Majority of people seem to have got it. They're only reinforcing what they're saying. That's when you put a stop on that. That's when you press the stop button. So we'll stop that particular forum discussion at a time when it peaks. Why? Social ensures voluntary collaborative learning through experience and opinion sharing. Now, experiences and opinion sharing are what we started discussing. But after a point of time, experiences run out and opinions take up dimensions which are like something else altogether. When the optimal number of opinions and experiences have been shared, and you are the best judge on that as to how many right experiences have come in and how many you've been able to channelize and help the people understand. And that is when you just put a stop on that. So what do? Immediately you follow up with a game-based quiz. Link to a leaderboard. Very easy. Game-based quizzes you can create very, very, very easily using any common tools in the market. If you want, Excel Pro provides a lot of game-based templates for you to create quizzes. If you don't have game-based quizzes, no problem. Go to LMS, create a normal MCQ quiz. If you don't have an MCQ quiz, no problem. Just type in a text over there and see who are the people answering. Any medium is fine. Any medium is fine as long as you run a quiz, run a game. If you don't have an online leaderboard, we can provide it for you. If you can't take it from us, you're in a hurry, not an issue. You do a leaderboard on paper, pull it up, people will see it, happy. The idea is to get the experience, not to get bogged down by technology. That's the whole message here. If you can reach out to companies like Excel Pro or any other companies in the market who can help you and have got time for that, all can be done. If that is not possible, you can still do it, but don't let a technological handicap cause any problem for you. That's not an issue. Go ahead and find an alternative way to do it. It can happen. How? All of us were used to working from office for so many hours, extra hours, every day, every week, weekends. Were we used to sitting at home for 3 weeks or 2 weeks constantly and working from home? We were not. But are you working? Yes. Have you adapted? Definitely. Something else happened altogether. So adaptation is the name of the game. And I would like you to adapt to everything, but ensure that a game is played, a quiz is given, and a leaderboard comes out. Why? Till now, the people are collaborating. Suddenly, the same collaborators, you're making them compete. When they compete, a scoreboard leaderboard tells us who is on top, who is not. Now, why should it be done? Because there is more coming in after that. In social learning, it is constant collaboration and constant competition. So collaboration, competition keep on happening constantly. So when somebody gets some names and numbers here, he or she feels good and proud, but there are 10 others out there who will say, wait, in the next instance, we're going to beat you on that. And that is the spirit we're talking about. So once it is done, make an online announcement with a summary and conclusion and use the opportunity to launch the next topic. That is how the link is built in the chain. So you completed one cycle, announce the results, announce a summary, what is the learning, share the names of people who really did some fantastic work, share experiences, understanding is over, and seamlessly bring in the next topic, and the whole journey continues. The saga continues, or the next topic, the next topic, the next topic, and whole learning pedagogy is followed smoothly one after the other after the other. So you're engaging your audience, you're involving them in a manner that they're able to share the experiences, you're moderating it, you're concentrating on the topics, one small topic at a time, all the while ensuring that you're making the best use of time and the constraints which are put in front of you. All sounds good till you start. So if all this is sounding so fantastic and all is good, how do you get started? Getting started is very important, and the first step is the most critical step to take. And the first step I recommend is prepare. Nothing happens automatically. You might be a great genius. You might be a trainer with 20, 30 years of experience, even more. You might be somebody who's got the best of qualifications. You might be somebody who's like a superstar trainer or a learning expert. It doesn't matter who you are. Whoever you are, prepare. Because this is something you're dealing with for the first time. How much ever you know about the subject, the circumstances are new to you and to your learners too. So I always recommend prepare very well. Focus on the topic, then slice it down to subtopics and focus on subtopics. Why should I keep this as a part of my intervention right now? What qualifies for it? Is there any way I can break it further? Unleash the spirit with your words and voice. Now, this is very important because your words and voice mean a lot to your learners. Do not try to outsource the voice or also, because it's you. You as a person, your positive energy, that is important. Why? Because positive energy and enthusiasm is more viral than any virus the world has ever seen or will see. This is a very strong statement I'm making because we're dealing with a virus out there in the world. But the world viralness, how much of a virus brings in, positive energy is something so fantastic that human beings possess. And you use your energy to unleash a spirit with your audience. When you do that, you build your own style of engaging. Why should you build your own style? Because you are unique in your own way. You might not be a great orator. How does it matter? As long as you got the subject, you got the positive energy, you got the enthusiasm, Choose the right words and voice and unleash. Do not try to be put on or clone. Just be yourself in the social world. Authenticity is very, very important. It matters a lot. It doesn't matter again if it does not work the first time. Usually most things, rather a lot of great things, never work the first time. We all know the example of Thomas Edison and how many times he had to go through creating a bulb, and finally he did create a bulb. And there's a famous quote when Edison says, like, you know, it's not failures. He knew how many times it didn't work, and now he knows finally it's worked. When you look at examples like that, what kind of motivation would have made those people to go all out to get what they want? All you're required to do is go all out to unleash your content with your learners using the opportunity in front of you and with a clear focus. If you don't get it right, do it again, 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 and again, and eventually it'll happen. Now, when I speak of the core focus, when I speak of the concept, context, and your learners, I'm emphasizing very, very heavily on your attitude towards this thing and your belief that I'm not going to bog down by any technological issues. I'll make it happen. While you'll make it happen, you can use any social tool. As I've been saying from the beginning of the session, you can use any social tool of your choice as long as you and your learners are comfortable. Both of you being comfortable is important. If any of you is not comfortable, then the process might be a little uneasy or a hiccup and figuring out. It may not give the best feel. If you're not comfortable, your audience is comfortable, take some time to warm up to the tool, use it, be familiar, and then get started. If your audience does not use any of these tools and you're figuring out something, or you've got a corporate LMS within which there's a forum, then get people to familiarize. Remember the first step I spoke about? Use the first step to familiarize them and eventually get started with the learning. You can use blogs, WhatsApp groups, discussion forums, LinkedIn groups, Facebook, Hangout, anything. As long as you're familiar, you can choose, it works for you. In conclusion, first and foremost, focus on a specific topic. Go live. Go live is very important. Never have a social engaging event without you being live on it. Engage in moderated online discussions. Extremely important, because that is where it goes beyond you into your audience. They start co-creating, peer-to-peer creation moderated by you. Run a game with leaderboard towards the end to convert collaboration into competition, to induce a spirit for people to start linking to the next topic. Conclude and restart with next topic, and that's how one cycle ends, and unleash yourself onto your intervention. Enjoy every minute of it, be passionate, and the whole dimension of social learning will have a new meaning for you altogether. In the end, there's always a first time, and today is the day and time. That's how I believe it. If you have been with me in the webinar till now, you realize that the entire core focus is on spirit, is on your attitude, your desire to take learning to a new dimension, using a constraint to create something beautiful and fantastic. And if you believe in it, you can definitely do it. And that's the whole message I've got for you here today. While I'm delivering the message, one strong point of support also, while you're on your journey of creating social learning intervention in this time of social distancing, or maybe later, if you need my help or help of my colleagues any point of time to create small games, create videos, create animations, you don't have a platform, want an LMS, we can launch a Moodle LMS for you in 24 hours flat, because we're doing it for companies right now. We have a very strong team which can take care of all these things for you. You need some advice on that, want a friendly advice on that, all you need to do is come to my website, playaccepto.com, type in your query over there and drop in your mobile number or an email, and one of us or even me will come back to you. Information is free, knowledge we'll share with you, our support is assured. Go out there and make it happen. My best wishes to all of you. On that note, it was nice having you with me in this webinar today. I hope you enjoyed learning about social learning in the era of social distancing. Wish you all the very best. Thank you. Have a great day ahead. Take care. Bye-bye.